Thank you very much. It's a great honor to have President Moon of South Korea with us, and a very, very great privilege to have Mrs. Kim. Thank you very much, very much. We hope you enjoy your stay. We are discussing many, many important things, including, obviously, North Korea, the relationships with North Korea. I had, in many respects, a very good meeting. We did not fulfill what we wanted to, but in many ways, certain things were agreed to. My relationship is very good with, as you know, Chairman Kim, and I think that it will go on that way. We'll see. We'll probably know, but we'll be discussing that. We'll be discussing trade, military purchases. South Korea buys a great deal of equipment from us, especially military equipment. Please, go ahead.
네, 먼저 그 문 대통령을 오늘 백악관에 환영하게 돼서 매우 그 영광을 생각합니다. 또 특히 김 여사님을 백악관에 환영하게 된 것은 아주 상당히 그 영광을 생각합니다. 오늘 우리는 여러 가지 다양한 중요한 문제를 논의할 것입니다. 물론 그 북한과의 관계에 대해서 논의할 것입니다. 그 우리가 지금까지는 북한과의 아주 좋은 그 회의를 가졌지만 원하는 목적을 달성하지는 못했습니다. 하지만 여러 문제에 있어서 서로 합의에 이른 것이 사실입니다. 우리는 그 김정은 위원장과 좋은 관계를 가지고 있습니다. 물론 앞으로 어떻게 진행이 될지는 두고 봐야 되겠습니다. 한국과 또 여러 가지 무역이라든지 군사 문제에 있어서 우리는 여러 가지를 논의하게 될 것입니다. 한국은 여러 장비, 특히 군사 장비 등등을 미국에서 많이 구매를 하고 있습니다.
We've just recently completed a new and very, very large trade deal with South Korea, and it's just now going into effect, and it will very much increase trade both ways between our two countries. It's a very important transaction and something we've been working on for quite a while. I know that for years they've been working on trying to redo it, and we have a new deal, and it's been, I think, very, very good for both our countries. Big difference.
우리는 최근에 그 한국과 미국 간에 상당히 중요한 무역 거래를 또 타결을 하였습니다. 그리고 지금 곧 효력이 발생할 예정입니다. 이 그 협정은 양국의 무역을 증진하게 될 것이고 아주 상당히 중요한 거래입니다. 이 그 협상에 대해서 오랫동안 우리가 재계약에 그 합의를 타결을 했습니다만은 이 이번 타결로 인해서 양국 모두에게 상당한 이익이 올 것으로 생각이 됩니다.
President Moon and South Korea have agreed to purchase a tremendous amount of our military equipment, from jet fighters to missiles to lots of other things. And we make the finest equipment in the world by far, and we appreciate the purchase. It's a very large purchase, and we always appreciate that.
문 대통령께서는 미국의 여러 군사 장비를 구매할 것으로 결정을 하셨습니다. 거기에는 제트 전투기라든지 미사일 그 외에 여러 가지 장비가 있습니다. 미국은 세계 최고의 그러한 장비를 만드는 나라입니다. 하지만 이런 큰 구매를 해주신 데 대해서 감사드립니다.
I think I can say that our relationship has never been better. Our relationship is on a personal basis, very, very close. First ladies, likewise, extremely close. And I think that that will continue for a long time into the future, forever.
우리 두 사람의 그 관계도 상당히 좋습니다. 우리 양국의 관계도 물론 좋습니다만은 그 어느 때보다도 한미 양국의 관계는 지금 더욱더 아주 긴밀합니다. 개인적으로도 우리가 긴밀한 관계를 가지고 있지만 두 영부인들도 상당히 아주 가까운 그런 관계를 가지고 있습니다. 이 좋은 관계는 우리 양국 간에 또 우리 개인들 간에 앞으로 영원할 것입니다.
So we'll be having individual meetings later on and all throughout the day with different people from different departments and representatives. The President and myself will be meeting right now in the Oval Office. Then we'll meet with our groups in the Cabinet Room, as you know. And I think it'll be very productive. It's going to be a very productive day. I just do want to tell you that great progress has been made and a great relationship has been made in North Korea, too. Kim Jong-un has been really somebody that I've gotten to know very well and respect. And hopefully, and I really believe that over a period of time, a lot of tremendous things will happen. I think North Korea has a tremendous potential. And I believe that President Moon agrees with that. And we will be discussing that and even potential meetings, further meetings with North Korea and Kim Jong-un. So I want to extend my warmest wishes to the people of South Korea. And I think indirectly, I can truly say I want to extend my warmest wishes to Kim Jong-un and the people of North Korea. I think the relationship has become far different and far better than it was when I first took office, or at the end, certainly, of the Obama administration. And it's a great honor to be with you, Mr. President, and thank you very much.
오늘 우리는 1대1 정상 간의 회의를 할 것이고, 또 하루 종일 여러 부처 담당자들이 한미 간에 많은 그 회의를 하게 될 것입니다. 먼저 나는 문 대통령과 집무실에서 회의를 할 것이고, 또 이것이 끝난 다음에는 캐비넷 룸에서 여러 강료들과 함께 좀 더 큰 회의를 할 것입니다. 오늘 상당히 생산적인 하루, 생산적인 회의가 될 것으로 생각합니다. 북한에 관해서 말씀드리자면은 아주 많은 진전이 있었다고 생각이 됩니다. 그리고 아주 좋은 관계를 우리가 가지고 있습니다. 나는 김정은 위원장을 아주 잘 알게 되었고 지금 존경하고 있습니다. 희망하건대 앞으로 시간이 가면서 좋은 일이 일어나기를 바라고 있습니다. 북한은 아주 커다란 잠재력을 가지고 있습니다. 그리고 그 잠재력에 대해서는 문 대통령도 동의를 하고 계십니다. 따라서 북한 문제에 대해서 논의할 것이고, 또 북한의 잠정적인 우리 어떤 잠재력을 가지고 있는 우리 다음 회의에 대해서도 또 잠재적으로 논의를 하게 될 것입니다. 여기에서 한국 국민들에게 그 안부를 전하고 싶습니다. 그와 동시에 김 위원장과 또 북한 주민들에게도 안부를 전합니다. 우리는 그 북한과의 좋은 관계를 지금 가지고 있습니다. 내가 대통령이 되기 전에 오바마 행정부라든지 이러한 것이 되기 전에보다 지금 훨씬 더 잘 좋은 관계를 가지고 있습니다. 앞으로도 계속 그 대화하게 되기를 바랍니다.
네, 감사합니다. 우리 예배를 백악관으로 초청해 주시고 또 이렇게 따뜻하게 환대해 주셔서 감사드립니다. 특히 어제는 저희가 머무는 그 영빈관으로 트럼프 대통령께서 아주 아름다운 꽃다발과 함께 직접 서명한 카드를 보내주셨습니다. 그렇게 세심하게 마음을 써주신 것에 대해서 아주 감동을 받았습니다. 특히 우리 제 아내가 아주 큰 감동을 받았습니다.
Mr. President, I would like to thank you for inviting our couple to the White House and also warmly welcoming us. In particular, last night at the Blue House, I saw the flowers, the beautiful flowers that you had sent with a personally signed card. I was really moved by your meticulous care, and especially my wife was moved.
먼저 미국에 두 가지 감사를 표하고 싶습니다. 첫 번째는 얼마 전에 한국의 강원도에서 큰 산불이 발생했는데, 그때 주한 미군에서 헬기를 보내주는 등으로 해서 진화 작업에 큰 도움을 주었습니다. 많은 한국 사람들이 감사하고 있습니다.
In particular, I have two accounts on which I'd like to express my gratitude to the United States. First, recently there was a big forest fire in Korea, in the province of Gangwon. At the time, the USFK supported us through the provision of many helicopters, and this really helped us put out the fire, and lots of Korean people were very grateful for this.
Thank you. 두 번째로는 오늘은 대한민국 임시정부가 수립된 100주년이 되는 우리 한국 국민들에게는 대단히 의미 있는 날입니다. 미국 의회 하원과 상원에서 그 대한민국 임시정부 수립 100주년을 기념하는 그런 결의안을 발의해 주신 것에 대해서 감사드리고 싶습니다.
And today is a meaningful day for all the Korean people because it marks the centenary anniversary of the establishment of the Provisional Government of Korea. And I heard that both at the Senate and at the House, they introduced a resolution celebrating this momentous day. So I'd like to thank you for that also.
작년 6월 12일 트럼프 대통령께서 북한의 김정은 위원장과 회담을 가진 이후에 한반도 정세에는 아주 극적인 변화가 있었습니다. 그전까지는 북한의 거듭되는 미사일 실험과 핵 실험으로 인해서 군사적 긴장이 아주 팽배했고, 그것이 언제 터질지 모르는 일촉즉발의 그 위기 상황에 있었는데, 트럼프 대통령께서 김정은 위원장과 직접 만나신 이후에 한반도의 군사적 긴장은 대폭 완화되고 아주 평화로운 그런 분위기가 감도되게 되었습니다. 그리고 북한의 핵 문제조차도 트럼프 대통령께서 대화로서 반드시 해결해 낼 것이라는 믿음을 우리 한국 국민들은 가지고 있습니다. 이 한반도 정세의 극적인 변화는 전적으로 우리 트럼프 대통령의 아주 강력한 또 탁월한 리더십 덕분이라고 믿습니다. 감사드립니다.
And after you had met Chairman Kim in Singapore on June 12th last year, we have witnessed a dramatic turnaround regarding the political situation on the Korean Peninsula. Previously, because of the repeated nuclear and missile tests from North Korea, we saw that the military tension at the time had been at its greatest, and we were in a very precarious situation. However, since you met Chairman Kim and you initiated personal diplomacy with him, we saw the dramatic, significant reduction of military tension on the Korean Peninsula, and now peace has prevailed. And also in terms of North Korean nuclear problem, all the Korean people have now we believe that you will be able to solve this problem through a dialogue. So I have to say that this dramatic turnaround that we have witnessed is solely down to your strong leadership.
Thank you very much. 그렇게 생각한다면 지난번 제2차 하노이 이게 북미 정상회담도 결코 실망한 일이 아니라 더 큰 합의로 나아가기 위한 그런 과정이라고 생각합니다.
Well, in this sense, I believe that the Hanoi summit was not a source of disappointment, but it is actually the part of a bigger process that will lead us to a bigger agreement.
그래서 이제 그 중요한 것은 대화의 모멘텀을 계속 유지시켜 나가고 또 가까운 시일 내에 제3차 북미회담이 열릴 수 있으리라는 그런 전망을 세계에 심어주는 것이 중요하다고 생각합니다.
So the important task that we face right now is to maintain the momentum of dialogue and also express the positive outlook regarding the third U.S.-North Korea summit to the international community that this will be held in the near future.
그 점에 대해서 트럼프 대통령께서 계속해서 김정은 위원장에게 신뢰를 표명해 주시고 이렇게 북한이 대화의 궤도에서 이탈하지 않도록 이렇게 잘 관리해 주신 것에 대해서 아주 높이 평가하며 감사 말씀드리고 싶습니다.
So in this regard, I'd like to express my high regard for how you have continued to express your trust towards Chairman Kim, and also you have made sure that North Korea does not deviate from the dialogue track. I'd like to express my gratitude for this.
우리 한국은 미국과 함께 북한의 완전한 비핵화의 최종적인 상태, 그 비핵화의 목표에 대해서 완벽하게 동일한 생각을 가지고 있고 그 다음에 또 빚을 틈 없는 그런 공조로 완전히 문제가 끝날 때까지 공조해 나갈 것이라는 것을 약속드리겠습니다.
And let me reiterate that the Republic of Korea is absolutely on the same page when it comes to the end state of the complete denuclearization of North Korea. And I can reassure you that we will remain in such great collaboration with the United States. There will be no daylight until we achieve our ultimate goal.
Thank you very much. I have to go just one step further, and I want to thank China, who's really helped us a lot at the border. I also want to thank Russia, because they have helped us, and they've helped us quite a bit more than people think at the border. So both China and Russia have really been quite good. That doesn't mean they can't get better, but they've been quite good at the border, and I just want to thank both of those countries. As we've said, a lot of progress has been made. We will have further dialogue, and I look forward to it. My relationship with Kim Jong-un has been a very strong relationship. I've had some very strong relationships with others, but I have a very, very good relationship with Kim Jong-un, and I think you see that, and we'll see what happens. Hopefully, it'll end up in a great solution for everybody and ultimately a great solution for the world, because it is about the world. It's more than just this area. It's about the world. And frankly, the world is watching. I want to thank you for your leadership, Your leadership has been outstanding, and I look forward to talking about other things also, and in particular, all of that equipment that you're buying. We like that in the United States. We like that you buy our great equipment. So, again, thank you very much, and thank you for your leadership. Thank you.
한 가지 추가로 더 말씀드리겠습니다. 먼저 그 중국에 감사를 표하고 싶습니다. 국경선 국경 문제에 있어서 중국이 상당히 많은 일을 했습니다. 또 러시아에도 감사를 표합니다. 러시아도 다른 사람들이 생각하는 것보다 훨씬 더 국경 문제에 있어서 많은 도움을 주었습니다. 물론 그렇다고 해서 이 두 나라가 더 나아질 수 있다, 더 할 수 없다라는 것은 아닙니다만 일단 이러한 국경 문제에 있어서 도움을 준 데 대해서 감사드립니다. 우리는 많은 진전을 이뤘습니다. 그리고 앞으로 더 대화를 계속할 것입니다. 김정은 위원장은 나와 굉장히 강한 관계를 가지고 있습니다. 물론 내가 다른 세계 지도자들과 또 좋은 관계를 갖고 있지만 김 위원장과 좋은 관계를 가지고 있는 것이 사실입니다. 앞으로 더 두고 봐야겠지만은 희망한 건데 우리는 아주 상당히 좋은 결과를 낳기를 바랍니다. 이렇게 된다면 그것은 모든 사람들에게 좋을 것이고 세계에 좋을 것입니다. 이 문제는 지역 문제가 아니라 세계적인 문제입니다. 그래서 전 세계가 보고 있는 것입니다. 또 문 대통령의 지도력에 감사드립니다. 그리고 또 그 문 대통령 한국에서 미국의 장비를 구매해 주신 데서 감사드립니다. 미국은 그 미국의 장비 구매하는 나라를 굉장히 좋아합니다. 감사드립니다.
Okay. Yes, please.
Mr. President, are you on economic projects for South Korea and North Korea? Are you willing to allow some leeway and relaxing sanctions so that South Korea can pursue some more economic projects with North Korea?
Well, we are discussing certain humanitarian things right now, and I'm okay with that, to be honest. I think you have to be okay with that. And South Korea is doing certain things to help out with food and various other things for North Korea. And we'll be discussing different things inside. Again, the relationship is a much different relationship than it was 2 years ago. You remember what that was all about. And certainly during the Obama administration, where nuclear weapons were being tested, often where rockets and missiles were being sent up, in many cases, over Japan. And we are in a much different situation right now. So we'll be discussing that very much, actually.
Mr. President, Mr. President, do you still love WikiLeaks?
I know nothing about WikiLeaks. It's not my thing. And I know there is something having to do with Julian Assange. I've been seeing what's happened with Assange, and that will be a determination, I would imagine, mostly by the Attorney General, who's doing an excellent job. So he'll be making a determination. I know nothing really about him. It's not my deal in life.
What would you like to see happen? What punishment?
I don't really have any opinion. I know the Attorney General will be involved in that, and he'll make a decision. Okay?
Mr. President, are you pleased that your Attorney General yesterday said that there was spying into your campaign in 2016?
Yes, I am. I think what he said was absolutely true. There was absolutely spying into my campaign. I'll go a step further. In my opinion, it was illegal spying, unprecedented spying, and something that should never be allowed to happen in our country again. And I think his answer was actually a very accurate one, and a lot of people saw that, and a lot of people understand, many, many people understand the situation and want to be open to that situation. Hard to believe it could have happened. But it did. There was spying in my campaign, and his answer was a very accurate one. It could happen. A third summit could happen, and it's step by step. It's not a fast process. I've never said it would be. It's step by step. I enjoy the summits. I enjoy being with the chairman. I think it's been very productive. And it really is. It's a step by step. It's not going to go fast. I've been telling you that for a long time. If it goes fast, it's not going to be the proper deal.
Is a three-way summit with the leaders of the two
Koreas? Well, that could happen also. I think that would be largely dependent on Chairman Kim, because President Moon will do what's necessary. I know President Moon has been fighting this battle for a long time. He's done an excellent job. I consider him a great ally. And a lot of good things are happening. A lot of good things are happening in the world. Our economy is the best it's ever been. Our employment numbers, unemployment and employment are the best they've ever been. We have more people working right now in the United States than we've ever had before, almost 160 million people. And likewise, South Korea is doing very well. Their economy is doing very well. And I think our trade deal has helped that process. So we're sitting on two great countries right now, and we're leading two great countries, and we think that I can speak for myself, and I think I can speak for President Moon. We think that North Korea has tremendous potential, and really potential under the leadership of Kim Jong-un. Let's see how it all works out.
Mr. President, have you communicated with Kim Jong-un in the last 2 weeks since you told us?
I don't want to comment on that, but we have a very good relationship.
Mr. President, are you concerned that Barr said that he's not going to redact that report to protect your reputation?
No, I'm not concerned about anything because, frankly, there was no collusion and there was no obstruction. And we never did anything wrong. The people that did something wrong were the other side. The dirty cops and a lot of the problems that were caused. It's a disgrace what happened. And again, it should never happen to a president again. You're just lucky I happen to be the president, because a lot of other presidents would have reacted much differently than I reacted. You're very lucky I was the president during the scam, during the Russian hoax, as I call it. So, no, I'm not concerned at all. The bottom line, the result is no collusion, no obstruction. And that's the way it is. And I know a lot of people were very disappointed, but they knew the real answer. You know, when the Democrats go behind the scenes and they go into a room backstage and they sit and they talk, they laugh because they know it's all a big scam, a big hoax. And it's called politics, but this is dirty politics, and this is actually treason. It's a very bad thing that people have done. And I just hope that law enforcement takes it up. Because if they don't take it up, they're doing a great disservice to our country. Yes, go ahead, please.
I'm sure you guys also have heard of the agreement instead of being
by you. No, we're talking about long-term, and we always talk about long-term. We want to have long-term. Our relationship with South Korea is extraordinary, and we only think in terms of long-term with South Korea. Okay?
Mr. President.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Really difficult. Will you discuss about resume of Kaesong Industrial Complex and Mount Kumgangchul?
Explain that to me, please. What?
How much do you support President, my president's push for economic construction, which includes the resumption of the joint inter-Korean industrial complex and perhaps even the...
Well, at the right time, I would have great support. This isn't the right time. But at the right time, I'd have great support with North Korea. Great support. I think that South Korea, and I think Japan, and I think that the U.S., I think a lot of countries will be helping. China, I really believe, will help. I think that Russia will help. I think a lot of countries will help. When the right deal is made and when the nuclear weapons are gone, I just think that North Korea has potential as great as anything I've ever seen in terms of potential. They have an unbelievable location, surrounded by sea on two sides, and on the other side, Russia, China, and over here, South Korea. You just can't do better than that. And they have magnificent land. It has tremendous potential.
So the question was, if North Korea actually submits a roadmap regarding complete denuclearization, are you two, the two presidents, will you be discussing this issue at the summit meeting today?
Yes, we will. We will be discussing it. Certainly, that's a very prime topic for our meeting today, and we hope that's going to happen. Yes.
Is your position still that sanctions should stay in place on North Korea until there is denuclearization? Or are you willing to consider easing sanctions to keep the talks going?
No, we want sanctions to remain in place. And frankly, I had the option of significantly increasing them. I didn't want to do that because of my relationship with Kim Jong-un. I did not want to do that. I didn't think it was necessary. As you know, a couple of weeks ago, I held it back. But I think that sanctions are right now at a level that's a fair level, and I really believe something very significant is going to happen. We could always increase them, but I didn't want to do that at this time.
Mr. President, would you accept a smaller deal to keep the process going, as President Moon called it?
I'd have to see what the deal is. There are various smaller deals that maybe could happen. Things could happen. You can work out step-by-step pieces, but at this moment, we're talking about the big deal. The big deal is we have to get rid of the nuclear weapons. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You know, there are 15 players capable of winning, and I guess you could say there are a lot more than that. They're great players. I don't think a field for the Masters has ever been this deep. I was watching late last night, and they were going over the different players. I think the field has never been so deep, but always Phil and Tiger and Dustin. And you have so many great players, but they were just saying they're younger, they're stronger, they've never hit the ball this long, they've never hit the ball this accurately, they've never putted better than they do now. You know, the whole thing is pretty incredible, but the field is very, very deep. I think it's going to be a great Masters. I hope so. Thank you very much, everybody.